So in this whole motorcycle scene, what's something that you're personally most proud of?
I'm proud of build such a unique motorcycle and the people recognize me, who I am, and they became a good friend.
Right. Yeah. I mean, that's why we're having this conversation right now.
Yeah.
Because we're both passionate about motorcycles.
Yeah.
Motorcycles have brought me and you together.
Yeah.
Our friendship together.
Yeah. So I love about those kind of stuff about the motorcycle.
What's up, guys? I'm Jake from Prism Supply. Today, we're in Huntington Beach, California, featuring my friend Kay, the push-up master.
I can't do it.
What's up, guys? I'm Jake from Prism Supply. Welcome to our series, My Garage. In today's episode, we're in Huntington Beach, California, featuring my friend Kay. Kay is a chopper enthusiast, a true artist, a craftsman, somebody with an incredible attention to detail, and the push-up master. Let's go check out your garage. I'm excited to see it.
Sure.
Thanks for having us.
Yeah, thanks for coming.
All right, Kay, so now that we're in your garage,
yep.
Give us a little rundown of the overall space.
I'm just trying to keep minimum here because the garage is such a small, make a noise, and neighbor doesn't give a shit. They love me, actually. Yeah.
It's pretty sick that you have this space here in Huntington Beach.
Yeah, like, it's insane. Huntington Beach is actually crazy.
It's always like impressive to me when I can come into a garage that's like a smaller garage.
Yeah.
And a part of an apartment complex or
yeah.
condo complex, and still see people like you that are building these incredible ground up bikes.
Oh yeah, choppers. I don't even have a lift.
Yeah, you work from the ground.
Just like on your knee.
Very Japanese style, right?
Yeah, Japanese style. Yeah.
Are you typically a panhead guy?
I love panhead.
Yeah.
Yeah.
What do you love about a panhead?
Looks. Visually, panhead is the best to me, and I feel like panhead runs forever. It's not true, but I like panhead a lot. Yeah, my first bike was panhead. That's why I'm obsessed with it. When I was 20, I got a 49. Yeah,
crazy.
That was in Japan. I was 20 years old.
Sorry.
Expensive.
Crazy.
Yeah.
And you knew that you just wanted to be in.
I didn't even know what's the pan, I didn't even know what's the shovel head, knuckle, I didn't know anything. I just like, I want this, I just bought it. And then one day I just grabbed a 20K and just like give it to him. Hey, serious.
I want this bike.
Yeah, and finally he was like, oh, okay.
So was that first bike, was it a chopper or like a stock
yeah,
bike?
Yeah, chopper.
Crazy.
Yeah, like a tiny, tiny tight bar.
Do you still think it's cool today? Like that style of?
I think so, yeah.
Like
I
would you would own that bike?
Yeah, I would still build the same bike.
Incredible.
Yeah.
Nobody can say that.
Oh yeah. It's
over the years.
Such a cool bike. Yeah.
Wow. See if it's more quiet there.
Want a beer?
No, I'm okay. I'm okay. Maybe later.
I sold it because I need the money to move here.
But what brought you here to the States?
Basically study English.
Okay.
Yeah. Every time I'm just like, all right, next year I go back home, but good things going on. I don't want to go home.
You know, yeah,
I just stuck here. Yeah.
How'd you get into building bikes? Like, what was that
so
turning point for you?
This is funny. The first year or so, I didn't know anybody else, and no English. It's boring, you know. It's nothing to do. So I just like scoring the Craigslist to find a motorcycle. I was like, all right, I should buy it. I should build it. I have no idea how to build bike. When I was in Japan, I never changed even oil.
Okay.
Yeah, and I bought the bike. The first bike is that black bike, and that was a pen shovel, 65 pen shovel. No English, I just cracked this, like I hit the guy up. Hey, this is a Bravo. He's like, yes, come get it. It's like little ghetto trailer park in Lakers now. The guy came out butt naked. I mean, he was like wearing the underwear, but just like a naked guy.
Like whitey tighties, like.
Yeah, and like missing teeth and long hair. I got scared. Like, dude, I'm gonna get robbed. But
and you had cash.
I got a cash, yeah. But it was super, super cheap. Like incredible cheap. But I just, yeah, load up the bike. And then like, I don't have any tool. I don't have a garage. And I was like staring at the day, 10 hours all day. I don't know what to do. So I just like went to swap meet, grabbed like a couple tools and start building. Just stripped down everything first. The reason why I love chopper is like such a unique and whatever idea you have, you can just like bring them in real life. So things just come
out. But the sky's the limit. You can do whatever you want.
Oh yeah, sky's the limit. That's the word.
Make it as custom as you want.
You know, like the bike actually just like express the who built the bike, who you are, you know?
What kind of advice would you give somebody that's trying to get into building motorcycles, regardless of like the type of motorcycle that it is?
I don't know, like the advice, like I'm not the guy, I'm not the great guy to just give them advice or anything.
Yes, you are. No. Dude, you moved here from Japan and you figured it all out on your own. Of course you're the guy to give advice.
I would just tell them, just like any bike you get, like love them.
Love it?
Yeah, love it. And just like ride it every day. Something break down, don't get pissed. So most of people just like don't know, just like break down, oh, I hate this shit. Dude, love it. That's the moment you should love. You know, breaking down, you fix it, and you just know what's going on. It's like your wife, it's like a girlfriend, you know? Right. I would just give that kind of advice. Details, I love the details.
Yeah.
Yeah, on the motorcycle. Every time you see it, just like you find the different details.
Yep, exactly.
Yeah, that's my just like a passion about it, yeah.
And which I feel like that's very your style, like, I can stand back and look at your bikes and overall they look relatively simple, right? But as soon as you get closer, you notice all the custom work that went into all the molding, all the small details. Yeah. And that's like the style that I really like and I respect about the bikes that you build.
Yeah.
I'm such a hard worker, but like if I don't stop, I don't stop working all day. That's kind of like my mindset. The reason why I was like, I love firefighting.
So you were a firefighter?
Yeah, I was a firefighter, yeah.
In Japan?
In Japan, yeah.
Okay.
It's in the fire academy is like so hard. Like you stay in the academy and then sleep there with 100 people like 6 months straight. Something happened, you get punishment, 200 push-ups, blah blah blah. Such a strict world. It's a military.
It's boot camp.
Yeah, boot camp. Like so hard. It's crazy.
So this paint head's incredible. This is the one I was saying that like as you get closer you just start to notice all the details.
Little details.
And this is your favorite bike?
Yeah, this is my favorite bike. 23 front, 19 rear. I don't think anybody.
Nobody who runs a 23 inch front wheel.
Yeah.
And it definitely gives it like a unique stance, especially with that 19 inch.
Yeah.
The 23 and the 19.
So like it looks like a 23 and a 19, just like such a big tire to make spike small. And like, I like the just visual of it.
And then the double Z handlebars?
Yeah, double Z is such a nightmare to make it. Yeah.
You made those handlebars?
Yeah. And I just like, I used to, the cable go through, internal cable go through down here.
Mm-hmm.
It took me 3 hours to go through it.
And you're like, I'm not doing that again?
No, never.
So then you ran it out of here?
Yeah, I just like make a hole. That's much easier.
Oh, and then this is the bicycle hub. Course.
Yeah, this is the bicycle
hub. That's genius. That's
so
great.
Smooth, yeah.
I know, I remember feeling that before. That's crazy. That's so sick.
Yeah.
I love that idea.
Yeah.
How many kicks does it take to start? I'm gonna put you on the spot.
Five.
Five?
Well, maybe, I'd say three kick.
After the prime. You prime it? So,
two prime, three kick.
Let's see it.
Okay.
Prove it to me.
Let's see it.
What's your starting sequence here?
Choke twice.
Choke fully on?
Yeah.
Yep.
Twice. Choke on.
Choke off fully?
Yeah, off. Yeah, off.
And then ignition or no?
Yeah, it's ignition. One.
One.
Two.
Woo! There it is. He nailed it.
Oh, yeah.
Three kick. Yeah. You did it. You nailed it.
Nailed it.
There you go.
Let me try this one.
What's that? Oh boy.
Go back.
Well, I don't think I can do that one. What's the trick?
Yeah, just got pink. Yeah, oh yeah, got it. Couple exercise.
That's
good
a tough
job.
One. No, is it no true you do whatever year it is on New Year's Eve, you do that many push-ups?
Yeah, number of the years. The New Year's Eve, that's how I celebrate the New Year's. Yeah.
So you just did 2023
last
push-ups.
Year. I did, yeah.
What's it feel like?
I don't, you honestly, you don't feel anything. Cause like after maybe 500 or 700 push-ups, like your elbow is just like numb, chest, you don't feel, it's all about mental. And it took me 7 hours.
So in this whole motorcycle scene world, what's something that you're personally most proud of?
I am proud of
build such a unique motorcycle and people recognize me, who I am, and they became a good friends.
Right. Yeah. I mean, that's why we're having this conversation right now.
Yeah.
Because we're both passionate about motorcycles.
Yeah.
Motorcycles have brought me and you together.
Yeah.
Our friendship together.
Yeah. So I think that's the good part of like the motorcycle. But it's such easy to just like having this conversation, we on the same page, just like having
passionate like, about the passion, same thing.
Yeah. Yeah. Right. So I love about those kind of stuff about the motorcycle.
So you were telling me
yeah, this guy.
That you had that under that bike.
Yeah. Yeah. Like that. Oh shit. It's moving.
I'm scared.
And this thing's like, I don't want to do it. But kick back, full swing to my head.
Boom. Boom.
And I knocked out, seriously. I was like, oh.
You just fell.
Oh yeah.
This boom. And this is 2 days ago.
Yeah. Like here.
So swollen.
Straight in my head.
Dude, I'm glad you're
ball fight. Ball fight. Just like somebody swung the pipe in my head.
Oh no. What made you like Harley-Davidson?
Oh, okay. It's just a cool. Like
it's simple as that.
Yeah, it's simple. It's just Harley is cool and like greatest motorcycle in the universe for sure.
You know?
Easy, looks cool, and I like the torque of it, like big twin. Love it, like every moment of riding a motorcycle. Yeah, Harley is sick. Harley's just sick.
Yeah. Simple as that.
Yeah.
That's it for this episode of My Garage. Okay, thank you so much for having us, opening up your doors to us. Your spot is incredible. Thank you for sharing it with us. Where can we find you?
Huntington Beach.
Huntington Beach. And on Instagram?
On Instagram, yeah, steels21.
At steels21, yeah. Cool.
Thank you so much.
Yeah, of course, thank you, brother. Appreciate you.
Yeah, thanks for coming.